All right. So I'm Christian Nolan. I am the Vice President of Web Development for emagine. We are a full-service digital agency with offices in Massachusetts here and in Florida. We specialize in business-to-business clients. We work in healthcare, high-tech, biopharma, construction, and we primarily develop on WordPress. So what I do, one of the things I put a lot of focus on is efficiency and problem solving. So that's why today I will talk with you about WP CLI. WP CLI is a command line interface, and it allows you to work with WordPress from the command line instead of having to use the UI. And to a lot of people, this might seem like something that you don't really want to bother with because there already is a UI. WordPress has spent a lot of time making a UI. Why am I going to go and use anything outside of what WordPress has given me? Before I get into that real quick, though, this is the requirements if you want to be able to use it. You need to be on PHP 5.3.2.9 or later. You need to be running a more up-to-date version of WordPress, 3.7 or later. And you most likely need to be in a Unix-like environment. There is, if you're running a newer version of Windows, you can run it through their, because they offer Bash in the later versions, but most likely you're going to be in a Linux environment. So if you want to use WP CLI, you can either go to this first resource here and you can install it yourself. You'll need to have access to your server. You need SSH access. Or if you use somebody else you're hosting as your hosting provider, you can contact them. There's a full list of hosting companies that support WP CLI, and it's becoming more and more common. So you can just reach out to your hosting provider. If you use somebody like WP Engine, they have WP CLI in their administrative tools. It's not full WP CLI because they have some restrictions, but they do offer it. And if you just want to play with it, though, you can use VVV. It uses Vagrant. It creates a Linux-like environment for you, very similar to WordPress, comes with WordPress installed with it, and it has WP CLI baked in. So back to my point, why bother? So again, back to what I spend a lot of time working on, its efficiencies, its performance. So if we make a living off of WordPress and we start a new project, we have to spend time getting it up and running. We have to spend time supporting it. We have to spend time working through the administration of it. If we can trim time in any one of those places, we're now more valuable. What we provide to somebody, if it takes less time, it makes more money because we're spending less time on it. Henry Ford says that improved productivity means less human sweat, not more. So if you can do something that's easier and gets the job done faster, then you're being productive. You're being good at your job. And for me, 65%, that's the amount of time I save with setting up WordPress through the command line versus the 5-minute install. That's just one piece of it. There, you can manage WordPress completely from the command line, and you can save time, especially getting up and running. So when using WP CLI, these are the varying parts. You have WP, which is the WP CLI command. You have the command, which is the actual part of WordPress that you're going to be trying to manage. You have the subcommand, which is the section within that part that you're going to be, you know, doing, whether that's updating or adding. You then have options that can go against each command. And then you have global parameters that you can apply. So what I'm going to do now, instead of just talking about it, I'm going to take the time and show you a little bit of what it's like to use WP CLI. Can everybody see that okay? Okay. So right now I'm in a server that I set up using VVV. And just to give you a bit of an idea, this is the site right now. So there's nothing going on here. And so if I want to get WordPress installed and I have WP CLI in, I can type WP core download. And what this is going to do is it's going to go out to WordPress.org, it's going to pull down the latest version of WordPress, and it's going to unpack the files into my directory. So now if I go back to this page and reload, you see it brings up the installation. Next, I can set up my config. So one way to do this is type again. Everything's going to start with my WP command. And then I'm going to type in core, because I'm dealing with core WordPress. And I'm going to type config. Now, this gets back to when I talked about parameters and options. So some commands require options to be set, because it doesn't know exactly what it is that we need input. It needs to know. It can't read our minds. So when we set up a config, we need to think about wp-config.php. This is the stuff that we need to put in there. Now, I could go through each option, and I could write wp-core-config, and then write db-name equals, and write it all out. That's going to get tedious for you. Again, we want to do work as quickly as possible. So instead of that, we can use a global parameter called prompt. And this is going to step through the 12 required questions it has for setting up your config file and allow you to get you up and running. So let's see, my database name here, I will call it new site. My DB user on Vagrant, it's just root and root for the password, so don't do that in production. It's a good idea. If we leave something blank, it's going to use the default, so localhost. If I leave DB prefix by default, it's going to use WP underscore, but we don't want to use the default, so I'll just put in some random characters. I can leave the character set and collation by itself, the locale. Extra PHP would allow me to, if I wanted to write in maybe some custom salts, I could put that into the PHP section. Do I want to skip my salts? No. And do I want to skip the check? Yes. And force would, if you already had a WP config file there, it would override it. So there, it generated my WP config file. The problem is, though, I told it what database I wanted, but I don't have that database actually created. So I'm going to get this error establishing connection to the database message. So WordPress offers another section I can work in, which is the database. So I can just type wp-db-create, and it created that database for me. So we have WordPress downloaded, we have wp-config set up, we have our database created, but now we have to go through the installation. So again, I can type in wp-core-install, and I'm going to use that prompt global parameter again. And it's going to ask me all my questions that I need. So it's going to be called newsite.dev, title, username, my super secret password, email address. Do I want to skip getting that email? I do, so I can just hit enter. And now this is going to set up everything. It says WordPress is successfully installed. And there it is. So, we have WordPress installed now. What else do we need to do? When you guys set up WordPress, who here, what's the first thing you do when you install a fresh new WordPress using the 5-minute install? Plugins. That's right. So, let's start managing some plugins. So, WP plugin, and then we'll say list. This will give me a list of all the plugins that are currently available in this install. So, the first thing I should do no more Hello Dolly. And maybe we do want a Kismet, right? So we can say plugin activate and then the slug of the plugin we want to use. So just like when I did delete, I just passed the slug in. And it knows what plugin I'm talking about. It automatically activates it. So now if I go to my list, it'll say it's now active. So we can also work with what we know, right? We have, there's a lot of plugins on the repo. So maybe this is an e-commerce site, so I know I want WooCommerce. I can go in and type WP plugin install WooCommerce. And now that's going to go up to the repo, pull down the latest version of WooCommerce, and unpack it for me, and then it's going to be ready. I can choose to leave it inactive, or I can choose to activate it. So now when I go back to my list, it has WooCommerce there as inactive. You aren't limited to what's in the repo either, though. If there's a third party out there that has a zip file somewhere, or maybe you've made your own plugin but you don't have it in the repo, if you have a public-facing URL for that plugin, you can paste that in here instead. So use this as an example. So if I grab the Bright Cove Video Connector plugin, I can say WP plugin install, and that will just take that URL, grab it, and install it. So again, if you have, you know, maybe a proprietary plugin that you like to use that you don't want to make public, but you want to be able to expedite the time it takes to install them, you could include this into your workflow. The other option is you maybe have a client that you're dealing with, and or maybe a new release of a plugin's been put out there, and you know that there's an issue with it, and you don't want to contend with that right now. You can choose to install a previous version. So I can say WP plugin install Jetpack version equals 4.5. So instead of grabbing 4.6 of Jetpack, it's going to grab version 4.5. Because it can go back into the repo. Maybe it's not 4.5. Should be. Ah, thank you. Yep, but I'm making sure that I didn't actually type something wrong, which it doesn't look like it did. There you go. So it's grabbing 4.5 of Jetpack, and it's going to unpack and install it.
Why didn't it work the first
time? I don't know. It looks like it's the same. Maybe I'm on Wi-Fi. Maybe I lost my Wi-Fi connection for a minute. So the other thing you can do, too, though, is instead of going through and installing plugins this way and having to every single time WP plugin install, WP plugin activate, you could pass this into the parameter. So let me just grab another plugin. Oh, BuddyPress. So I could say WP plugin install BuddyPress dash dash activate, and then that will grab the plugin from the repo, install it, and activate it all at the same time. So now also too, we constantly have to go back to our sites, right? We have to make sure that they are staying up to date. So when you, instead of having to go into the admin interface to actually update your plugins, the other thing you can do is go and use the command line and see what updates are available, and tackle these updates one by one through the command line, or all at once.
Can you script this process?
Yes, and I'll show you that at the end. Okay, so installed it successfully and activated it. So you'll see here in my list of plugins now that I'll have a couple that have updates available. I can either say WP plugin update and put in the actual slug of it, and it'll update only that one, or you could say WP plugin update all.
Okay.
and it'll go through and it'll update every plugin that has an update available for it. I'm not going to go through that right now because I don't want to deal with the bandwidth. The other thing you can do, too, is if you have, I mean, we all, from time to time, inherit sites from other people, and if you don't know what a plugin is for, you can go back to that list, and you can say, oh, I'm not really familiar with Brightcove Video Connect, so you can copy that, and you can say WP plugin get and the slug of it, and it will go out from and get the information from it from the plugin repo. Also, if you're looking for something, right? So maybe we have WooCommerce installed and we want to see what plugins are out there, we could do a WP plugin search. And we can just say WooCommerce. And it will go out to the repo and will grab in paginated results what we have for WooCommerce. Right now it tells you that there are 3,500 plus plugins for WooCommerce. If I want to see more items per page, I could type in WooCommerce and update per page, and I could say 20, and then that will augment my results. Now I have 20 instead of 10. Or, if, like right now, we see that WooCommerce Image Zoom has 100% rating. That's great, but it's not a lot of context. Is that one person who's given a 100% rating, 5-star rating? So we can change that and pass in the fields parameter, and we could say we want the name, the slug, the rating number, which is what's currently there, but also the number of ratings. And that will, oh, fields. Plugin search. Fields. Name. Slug. Rating. There you go. So now we have a little bit of context. 100% rating, but only 4 people. So maybe I don't want to learn more about WooCommerce Image Zoom for that reason. Or maybe I have to take a deeper dive into it. Maybe I need to do a code review on the plugin. So WP plugins and WP themes work the same way. So I'm not going to delve into how you can use it with themes, but if you want to be able to search for themes or want to be able to manage themes on your site, you can do the same thing. I can just use WP theme list, and it will show me the list of themes that are available, and I can manage them the same way. I can delete these. I can search for new themes. I can activate a different theme. All the same type of stuff that you can do inside of the plugins part. So the next thing we can work with are posts. So if I say WP post list, this will give me a list of all the posts for the post type that are here. So it's a brand new install. All I have is Hello World. I can pass in post type, and I can change it to page, and that gives me my sample page. So we can kind of take an inventory of what we have in the system for our post content. The other thing we can do, though, is create posts. So maybe, you know, you do want to script something like this, and you know, it's just you want to do a simple test. You could say WP post create, and then you can pass in the post type you want to use and the post title. And you can even put in the post content too. And now that tells you we created a post with the ID of 3. So if I go back, you'll see here's my sample CLI post. By default, when you do this, it will mark it as draft. So if I want to update this to be published, I can do WP post update 3, because that's the ID. And I can say post status equals publish. And I see my post is published. So that's fine, but are you going to go through and keep creating posts this way? Probably not, but if you had to on the fly once, you could. The real power comes in with their generate option. So if we're making a blog, and one of the things we need to do is test pagination, we could go in and say WP post generate. I'm not going to give it a post type parameter because I want it to be a post, so I don't need to add. I can say my count, 100. It just made me 100 posts. And now I have 11 pages of pagination. That's fine, but what would be better is if we could get some content in there, because right out of the box, there's no content in any of these posts. All we have is just a blank screen. So we can kind of leverage other things that we know about the command line. So we can use curl. There's a utility out there for lorem ipsum. So there are lorem ipsum generators. This URL creates content for me, creates HTML content. And as I refresh it, it's going to create new content. If I take this URL and I put it in curl, so it's going to grab this URL, and I use what's called the vertical pipe. The pipe is going to take, it's going to pass what I do in this statement. It's going to pass the output into my next statement. And WP CLI is smart enough to listen that if I passed my parameter, if I pass this post content parameter in there, it's going to listen to see if anything was passed to it. So now I generated another 50 posts. But this time with content. Now the other problem with this though is it's one curl request generating the same content. So what would be really good is if I could get this to generate new content for every single post that gets generated. So for that, I could use a for loop in the command line. So I could say for five posts, do a curl. Say curl on that URL, post generate. In this case, because I'm only doing one thing, I mean, because I'm putting my iteration here, I'm going to say my post count is one. I have to pass that post content, and I have to say done. So it's a little more advanced, but I'm saying here's a for loop. I'm going to iterate through five times, and for each time I'm going to do a curl request against this URL, and I'm going to generate a post and insert that kind of content. So you can see every single time it's that URL and it's put. So now I have another set of posts, but this time dynamic content. So think about how much time this will save you as a developer, needing to be able to verify a design, needing to know how different content is actually going to work on your site out of the box. This gives you a really good playing field to start with, regarding your development. And this URL, which I can share out later, allows you to specify what type of markup you want. So the other thing we can work with, too, with WP CLI is imagery. Here has heard of the regenerate thumbnail plugin, right? Sometimes what might happen is you have a site, and maybe you've added in your theme a new size, a new crop, and you want to be able to have all of your assets, use that new. Now you would have to call that regeneration plugin. You'd have to select them, regenerate, have to go through all. CLI has the ability to command in there. So I'm going to do its import. So I have this directory called media library, and it is sitting up one directory up from where I am, and I have a folder full of pictures in there. So by putting the **, that means it's going to go through and it's going to allow me to just insert those images. Now if I go into the back end of WordPress, there they are.
So wait, did that just register items that were in a folder into the database?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Well, that basically does what the at the server plugin does.
Right. What's your favorite movie?
Requiem for a Dream.
Yeah. So instead, I'll keep with the theme, and I'll say Ghostbusters. So the other thing you can do is you can pass in a URL. So instead, I can say WP media import URL. It will go out to that site, grab it, import it. So if you're dealing with a client and you're maybe migrating, you're working on a new project, and they have their site which has all of their images on it, and you need to get those into the new site, if they could provide you with a list of URLs inside a spreadsheet, you could easily turn that into a command and pull all those things into WordPress without having to navigate the media library or any another cumbersome importing plugin. So back to what I was saying about regeneration, though. So if I added a new image size, I can say just WP media regenerate. It's going to ask me, do I really want to regenerate all these images thumbnails? I can say yes. And then I just went through and regenerated them all. If there's only one image I cared about, I could grab the ID and I could say WP media regenerate and pass the ID, and it will just do that one. So instead of the benefit to this too is just not just that you can do this from the command line, but the fact that this is now not more code overhead in your site. This is something that's baked in. You don't have to worry about updating another plugin. You don't have to worry about a security vulnerability in a plugin. This is a tool that's just residing on your server that only you can use, or whoever has access. The other thing you can do is manage options. So when you start a new site and you're in active development, what don't you want to happen? You don't want Google to index it? We can update that here. We can say WP options, update blog public 0. Now in the back end of WordPress, go to reading, discard search engines from indexing the site. You can do the same thing with description. So maybe you don't want that. We can say WP option update blog description, I think. Okay, we also have database things we can do with CLI. You saw before that I did WP DB create, and that allowed me to create the database that was in WP config. We can also export. If you're, again, maybe you, this is a client you do work for already, and you're going to start working on a new site for them, or they want to be moved to another server because it's more powerful, you can say WPDB export and give a file name, and it will generate an exported file for you. And that will reside wherever you are in your directory. You can import another file. So I can say WP... So here's my site now. I can say WPDB import. My new site. Actually, that's the same one. Never mind. it's import. It's using a different. It's using a different WordPress prefix. It works. Now, but I can show you like this, though. WPDB reset, that is a command that will allow me to completely nuke my data. And then I can say WPDB import. What did I call it? My site. And you didn't have to navigate PHP MyAdmin. You didn't have to jump between, you didn't have to use, you know, SQL Pro, you were able to do it just all through the command line. The other option is you can do search and replace here instead. So maybe you are dealing with data from a current WordPress site, moving it to work on a staging site, you don't want to use the same URL, you can do WP search replace. I could say new site and search for and replace it with really new site. And what that's going to do is it's going to do a serialized search and replace on the database, which is really important because we deal with things like widgets and other data that is stored in a serialized array. If you just do a simple search and replace on there from the database, it's going to not have the right index of characters and therefore it's going to break. So that is in lieu of using something like search and replace DB script or better search and replace.
Yep. We're moving stuff from legacy servers to new servers.
Yep.
I didn't realize that WP CLI had the serialized data, like could accommodate serialized data in this big data search and replace. So that's huge for me.
Yeah. Thank you. No problem. Yeah, it's great. WP Migrate DB Pro is also a fantastic plugin. So I don't hate on that either. But you can say here it did 189 replacements, and now if I go here, my site will be broken. But I can get it back. Thank you. Let's see. You see, this is just going to keep on spinning because it can't resolve. Now we're back. Okay, what else can we do here? So the other thing that's really helpful with WordPress or with this process in WordPress too is inheriting projects I've mentioned a couple of times. If you have no relationship with that client or you know nothing about what's going on, you don't know what state your WordPress site is in. It could be hacked for all you know in core. So we can use WP CLI to verify the health of a site with verify checksums. So this is a compromised install I have of WordPress. And it's going through and comparing this current WordPress install with what's on .org. And it's telling me that it can't find about CSS. It's telling me that WP includes cache is different than what they have on there, and it's telling me that the file, super evil file, no worries.php, shouldn't be there. So now, without you having to comb through the your new client's installation of WordPress, you can say with pretty good confidence that WordPress is not in a good spot right now, and we should be working with a brand new installation and also probably consider looking at your themes and plugins. So to that same point, though, there is a huge, rich package directory up there for WP CLI. So, and everything I'm talking about today pretty much can be found on wpcli.org. And there's this packages index that has tons of community contributed scripts that are all based off of WP CLI. Some doing very specific things, some being add-ons for existing plugins that you may use. In the same vein of this, we can add a package that will check not only the checksums on WordPress, but also on our plugins, our themes. Yeah. We have it installed. Just say WP package install, and you can do WP package. And you can see it is actually installed for you. If it's locked, there's not going to be any package in there. And you can then grab. I just want to grab the slug of this package. Oops. The package that you know. Through the package, grab it, install it, and then it's there for you to use. So in this case, I can do WP checksum. All. And that will go through and will look at all my plugins, all my themes, and it will tell me what the state is of all of them. And it's turned back saying that it found problems with three of them. If I want to know more information, I can say details. Details. And here it tells me that classic kismet-morespam.php was added, or that in the 2017 theme, 404.php has been modified, or that in 2016, searchform.php was deleted. So this is, again, more insight into, you know, the environment that you're working in for your clients for money. So if you're going to make WordPress your business, you know, you want to invest in the tools that give you the most amount of insight into what you're working on as fast as possible and with confidence. So, you know, open source tools like this become invaluable. So the last thing I wanted to show you is, as was brought before, can you bash this out? And you can. We can turn this into a script. So I have this site here, newproject.dev. Again, it's empty, just like a new site was. I have a bash file in this directory. This is my bash script. And I can say bash WP installer. And it's going to start asking me some questions. Are you sure you want to install WordPress? Yes. So it's now going to grab the most recent version of WordPress, it's going to unpack the files, and it's going to put it in this directory. I need to configure it. What's the database name? New project. The user, going back to the root. Host, we'll keep it localhost. We'll leave it with the stock prefix. Character set, locale, I don't care. PHP. Database doesn't exist. So I need to do WD create. It's skipping it because I already installed WordPress. New project. New URL is new project. Installed WordPress. It's going to clean up some things for me. It deleted Hello Dolly and Akismet. It deleted the 2015 and 2016 theme. It set the site to no index, no follow. I want my subscription to be bashing WordPress. Winky face. It's now installing some plugins, installing duplicate posts, installing manual image crop, installing MC table buttons, installing the redirection plugin, and activating along the way, installing WP sitemap, and then it's going to install Yoast. Now it's going to ask me, do I want to install WooCommerce? I'll say no. Do I want to install Gravity Forms for Salesforce? No. Do I want to import some sample images? Yes. It's then going to grab some images from my sample images directory. How many posts do I want to generate? I'll say 50. And then I'm done. Now then what? In less than 2 minutes, I have a new version of WordPress set up, putting the settings I want with 50 generated posts, with the plugins I want to use installed, with the parts I don't want removed. And now I don't have to worry about doing any of this. I can actually get on to the part that I paid to do, which is develop, not install plugins and themes. And that's about it. Does anybody have any questions?
Is there an uncompromise command?
Uncompromise command? And what's
you showed your compromise folder there. Is there
To like undo any of that stuff?
Well,
to fix it?
No,
but you have an option to run an update, and it can uninstall and reinstall your core WordPress. As far as the add-on package, it doesn't have that. You would have to deactivate, delete, and then reinstall those plugins manually. But it's giving you indication, though, that there's probably something bigger going on. You know, because even in that situation, if you run into something like that where checksums don't verify, you shouldn't be just fixing it. You have a bigger problem. There's a hole. There's a reason why someone got into your site, and you need to kind of take a hard look at maybe the theme or the plugins that you're using, and maybe that plugin that got compromised you don't want to use. We mean just like stuff that about what's going on, so you know what you can do with it.
Yeah, because like you know, if you know, you're just starting up, like you know, remember.
Yep, and so you. I just typed in help. Well, iterate the different ways that you can do. You can self and it will tell. Involved with WP CLI, the things that I found invaluable were talked by Sean Hooper and AJ Moore and Steve. The documentation that you find wpcli.org is amazing. If you check out the repo that's there for on WP CLI, the community on it's really strong. If you're already in the Slack, I would get CLI is now in terms of houses itself. The foundation, yeah. That when everyone is willing to help on it, especially the current maintainer, Daniel Bachhuber. He it's his, you know, he does a lot of great work with it, and he answers all questions. So, anything else?
Oh. I just wanted to mention, for stuff like search and replace, and a lot of the other options, you can do a dry run flag.
Yep.
First time around. So if you didn't want to, if you like accidentally mistyped your search and replace, if you do dry run at the end, it'll tell you like where it would fix, where it would change it, and how many before actually doing it. You just nix it at the end.
Yeah, absolutely do that. You don't, and also too, you probably don't want to do any kind of search and replace anyway in a live environment unless you really, really have to. A lot of these things I would consider doing inside a stage environment, and especially the use cases that I would find that you'll use it in, it would be, oh, I have a new site and I need to pre-launch it, and I plan on mapping my host file to the new domain, so I'm going to do a search and replace. Anything else?
Do any of the plugins interact at all, like redirects and CV useful?
Yeah, so there's two things. If you are a plugin author, you can write CLI commands for it. You can extend it, and they highly, highly, you know, encourage you to do so. So yes, a lot of plugins have WP CLI support, and so you can incorporate that into your own kind of bash scripting or into your just single commands. All right, thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.